and have my hair salon inside the Carlisle Hotel in Madison Avenue. And here we have Chantal Adair, one of my muse and model. And Chantal has all kind of lengths in her hair. You know, she's cutting her short, growing, lots of bleach, lots of. But you know, I like the hair like this because when the hair is bleached, it becomes like almost like a Play-Doh, you know. And you know, Chantal, you know, in regard to make what is possible and to also keep her, you know, funky enough and that she can do all kind of stuff. She has an undercut here, you know. So you can see her hair is undercut, almost like a short hair. So she can make her hair look very short. But let's say Chantal is getting married tomorrow or today. And we had that hair, so it's like, oh my god, you know, it's every kind of length, it's every kind of, and there's no proper style, you know, per se, except the fact that we have the undercut. When we show it, it always looks, you know, way funkier than if we have a full, one length hair. So what I did, I just curled with the curling iron this morning. And I'm gonna do like, I don't know, like these days I'm really into the pompadour look, you know. In French, pompadour, in English, pompadour. This is the same. I like the idea of the pompadour even on short hair, you know, that kind of like, you know, I think we're going back to that in a bit of a mix of rock and roll and Marie Antoinette, you know. It's like Stray Cats meet Marie Antoinette. So, you know, Stray Cats is also one of my favorite bands in the 70s. So the hair's prepared very, I recut a little bit the undercut. I love the idea that there's still some blonde on the end. Yeah. We wanted to do the color yesterday. Let's not do the color. It's great. I love hair like this. I wish we could do hair. It looks exactly like this today at the color. But, generally speaking, it's not happening. So here we go. So the hair is being prepared with a curling iron, you know, just to create a nice texture. And now we're going to tease it. Like in the old days. But the good thing of not being a junior stylist is that we really know how to tease. Okay. And again, hair is being bleached. It's so prone to be, to be teased, to be manipulated, you know? So as I always say, like, bleach hair is a bit like Play-Doh, you know? It takes the shape that we want to give it, so, you know? So as you can see, the hair really react promptly to the teasing, and I don't have to tease too much actually, you know. I'm using a hairspray from Fito. You don't have to be too and it's a hairspray was made with a fibrin of silk, so it's not damaging to the hair. It's actually pretty good to the hair. Top level hairspray and not damaging, and usually doesn't go together, you know. But in this case, it does. So here we're doing it on the back as some kind of a French twist. So here I'm taking the back. I don't want any volume right here. So it's almost doing like a little stitching, you know? See? And then that's how the volume becomes huge on the top, you know? And I want to leave the ends kind of free instead of. You know, the whole idea is to keep some free hands. You see, even if the hair is pretty short on the front, you can have these effects of long hair. The hair is not really long. I'm using the hairspray, it's a little stronger, you know, because I don't want the hair to collapse on the front. Okay? And that's from Fito also. I believe it's there. The workable holding spray. I don't really know the name in French. See, wherever I put the hair, it basically stays, you know? And it's fun because it's shoulder underneath. Being short and up, it creates a nice base for the longer length on the top. And it's nice when I have a sideways mirror so I can see what's going on. So of course for a glide, we could something around, it's a little bit of bendable all around here. You see, I didn't even attach anything yet, you know, it's still kind of floating. Madame Pompadour, I forget my history of France, I'm here for way too long. Well, Madame de Pompadour was living under, I believe, don't quote me though, Louis the 14th. You know, and she was one of those ladies who were very social, you know. And I'm sure some people thought she was too social, but you know, it's very... But the hair was huge. I mean, this is big hair, right? I mean, you don't see that all the time, everywhere. But Madame de Pompadour had, you know, basically they had to, the anecdote is that when she went to a party and they had to raise the door for her to pass. But she couldn't pass the door, you know. But that's that whole idea, you know, of the Pompadour, like, you know, that very, like, that it's so big that there's no door frame who works for her. So now we're picking that with a little, not as dramatic. You see the volume on the side I really like, you know. It's, people forget sometimes of how we are perceived by others. You know, it's not necessarily from the face, because when you look at someone on the face, like if I look at you now, you know, I'm looking at your eyes, right? But when you observe someone, you observe that person for either the back, three-quarter of the back, the profile, three-quarter, you know? So everything has to, you know, that all, and respect that all oval, you know, I have this big theory of the oval in my haircut too. And even if it's crazy here, it's still respecting that oval, you know, shape, you know, all along. You know, I'm going to turn the chair very slowly here. You can see that. And this is done very quickly, you know, I mean, obviously, if it's a big wedding here, or, you know, it can be a little bit more refined, you know, I would say. But on the other hand, I like when we don't have much time, because I think hair looks more like alive, and it looks more like it's being instinctive, you know, versus prepare too long in advance, you know. You can, accessorize with anything, you know, for example, I don't know, I just put this here in case, it could be something like this, right? Maybe only one eye, but no. Yeah. It could be... Okay. New headband pretty on the front, way on the front like this, it's very pretty. You know, people are fancy that headband only goes on the top. That's kind of like, you know, a lame. Voila, and you see the back is fun. You know, maybe we could put some little jewelry here. You know, just hanging jewelry, maybe. Why not? Pearls. Diamonds. Yeah. Well, I think Chantal is ready now to either go to a, you know, party, getting married, or grocery shopping. No. It was so nice to be with you here this morning and evening with at the Carlyle Hotel in New York City. Thank you so much. Have a great day.